Welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss the procedure to convert the Moore machine into Millais machine with help of examples. Let's start the session. Given a Moore machine, we want to convert this machine into Millais machine. Q0 is our initial state. Input symbol are A and B, and output is depending upon the state only. So Q0 will give us 0 output. Q1 will give us 0 output. Q2 will give us 0 output and Q3 will give us 1 output. So first we will identify the output associated with each state. Then we will create the template of Millais machine, that is Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3. On reading of A, we are moving to a state and we are getting some output. On reading of B, we are moving to a state and we are generating some output. So on reading of A on Q0, we will move to Q0. So we will fill up these entry directly into the Millais machine. So it is Q2, Q3, Q0. Similarly, on reading of B, we are moving to Q1 state, Q1, Q1 and Q1. Now we will associate output with each of the target state, that on Q0 output is 0, on Q2 output is 0. On Q3 output is 1, on Q0 output is 0, on Q1 output is 0, on Q1 again output is 0, on Q1 again we will get output as 0, and on Q1 we will get output as 0. And this will be the equivalent Millais machines for the given Moore machine. So in step number 1, we will find out output associated with each state, and in the second step, we will draw the template of Millais machine and we will directly copy the target state from the Moore machines and then we will associate their corresponding output. In the previous session, we had designed a Moore machine over input symbol A and B that will find out how many times substring BAA occur. So we had designed the Moore machine by Q0 on reading of B. We are moving to Q1 and on reading of A, we are moving to Q2 and again we are reading A and we are moving to Q3 and we are associating 0 output with Q0, Q1 and Q2. And on reading of B on Q2, we are moving to Q1. On reading of B on Q3, we are moving to Q1. On reading of A on Q3, we are moving to Q0. On reading of A on Q0, we will remain in Q0. We can able to convert this into the transition table. Q0 is the initial state, Q1, Q2, Q3. On reading of A, we are moving to Q0, Q1. On Q1, if we are reading A, we are moving to Q2. On Q2, if we are reading A, we are moving to Q3. On reading of A on Q3, we are moving to Q0. On reading of B on Q1, we remain in Q1. On reading of B on Q2, we are moving to Q1. On reading of B on Q3, we are moving to Q1. And we are associating the output 0 with Q0, Q1 0, Q2 0, and Q3 output is 1. So this is a Moore machine. We want to convert this into Millais machine. So in the first step, we will find out the output associated with each state, with Q0 with 0, Q1 with 0, Q2 with 0 and Q3 with 1. We can directly able to find out it using the first column and the last column. Q1 with 0, Q2 with 0 and Q3 with 1. Now we will create the template of Millais machine. Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3. Q0 is our initial state. On reading of input A, we are moving to a state and we are generating some output. On reading of B, we are moving to a state and we are generating some output. So state we can directly copy from the Moore machine, that is Q0, Q2, Q3, Q0, that is this particular column, second column. Similarly, on reading of B, we are moving to Q1, Q1, Q1 and Q1, that is the third column of the Moore machine. Now we will generate the output associated with each state. With Q0, output is 0. With Q2, output is 0. With Q3, output is 1. With Q0, output is 0. with Q1 output is 0, with Q1 output is 0, 0 and 0 with Q1. So this will represent the equivalent Millais machine for the given Moore machine. Thanks for watching this session.